Hi, my name is Selim Solmaz, and I am a lead researcher at the Virtual Vehicle Research Center located in Graz, Austria. On behalf of the PRYSTINE project, I am now going to present you the demonstrator 2.4, which is about the passenger vehicle for low speed autonomy, or in short, PVLSA. Before I start the detailed description of the demonstrator, let me reiterate the PRYSTINE project's vision. PRYSTINE project aims to realize fail operational urban surround perception, or in short fusion, which is based on robust radar, lidar and camera sensor data fusion and developing the control functions to enable safe automated driving in urban and rural environments. Now let me briefly describe the goal of this demonstrator. Demonstrator 2.4, or namely passenger vehicle for low speed autonomy, aims to implement and validate the capabilities of fusion, that is fail operational urban surround perception components designed for use in low speed autonomy scenarios utilizing a passenger vehicle platform. According to the description of the demonstrator will serve as an initial evaluation platform for the developed perception and control algorithms at the end of the year 2, which is the summer of 2020. According to the use case descriptions, the vehicle has to back maneuver into a selected parking slot as selected from an HMI within a possibly dynamic environment. In order to realize this demonstrator, a number of software components, namely key fusion building blocks, were developed. These are occupancy grid filtering component, point cloud segmentation block, semantic segmentation component, object detection module, multi-object tracking component, and path planning for parking component. Here is the setup of the demonstrator vehicle. The test vehicle is based on the Ford Mondeo platform that belongs to the virtual vehicle. This vehicle is equipped with a data speed ADAS interface, which enables the controls of the vehicle. It is also equipped with a number of additional sensors that include a multitude of lidar, radar, and cameras. These sensors were used in conjunction with the development of fusion software blocks. The tests and use cases were implemented in an enclosed proving ground that belongs to ÖMTC, which is the Automobile and Motoring Club of Austria, located in Lang-Liebling, which is near Graz, Austria. This test track is selected because of the convenience of location as well as the suitability of the test track, which provides a wide and long stretch of proving ground, which is about 200 meters, which was used in conjunction with the use case development and testing. In the scope of the PVLSA demonstrator, two static and two dynamic scenarios were selected to verify and validate the algorithms developed. These are a static scenario, which is used for the occupancy grid filtering and semantic segmentation evaluation, a static scenario for evaluating occupancy grid filtering, a dynamic scenario to evaluate and validate multi-object tracking, object detection and point cloud segmentation, and finally, a dynamic scenario that is used to evaluate the path planning for parking. Here is an example validation test from static scenario 1 about semantic segmentation. According to this scenario, two vehicles and a pedestrian is in the field of view of the camera, and the goal is to segment or classify the available field of view into a number of known segments. So here is the output of the algorithm. So road users are accurately segmented and sharp segmentation boundaries are achieved despite the presence of strong shadows. In the next static scenario, we evaluate the occupancy grid filtering. A According to this scenario, we have a static vehicle and a pedestrian in the field of view of the camera, and there are two other pedestrians around the vehicle that are in slow motion. And here the aim is to form an occupancy grid around the vehicle, which can be used, for example, for trajectory planning purposes. Let's see how this algorithm performs. Obstacles are estimated as occupied space, which are in black. Obstacle free space is correctly estimated as free space. The space behind obstacles is not measured and hence is estimated as a gray area, which appears as a shadow. Occupied space is updated when the obstacle moves, and similarly, free space is updated when the obstacles move. As you can see, we can accurately form the occupancy grid around the vehicle utilizing the LiDAR sensor. In scenario 3, which is a dynamic scenario, we validate the object classification and object tracking algorithms. According to this scenario, the vehicle is moving in a dynamic environment, composing of other vehicles and pedestrians that are in motion. Here is how the algorithms are validated. First, we look at the object detection algorithm. The vehicle is approaching first to two pedestrians that are coming to the vehicle. Every detection is annotated with a class and a confidence score. When the pedestrians come close to each other, they are clustered together and cluster information is lost for a couple of frames, but then later associated again. When the objects leave the camera's field of view, their class information is lost forever. So the vehicle is starting to move again. The distant pedestrians is detected despite being only covered with a number of very small number of lines. There's a parked vehicle which is detected even though only a small portion of it is visible. Next, the vehicle is completing a complete U-turn and then approaching to two objects, one pedestrian and one vehicle. The distant vehicle is not fully detected due to the small number of points covering it, but as the vehicle gets closer, now it is detected fully. Next, we look at the object tracking algorithm. Again, using the same scenario, we see that there are numbers associated with every object in incremental numbers. IDs are preserved even during complex maneuvers, as in this case, they are crisscrossing each other. So the vehicle is speeding up again and coming to a U-turn. So new objects are associated with incremental numbers. Trajectories are extrapolated when objects leave the sensor field of view as expected. Now the vehicle is completing the U-turn and coming to the two objects that are approaching. First, the pedestrian is detected, and then the vehicle. Right. Next, as part of the scenario number 4, which is a dynamic scenario for evaluating path planning algorithms, we show an example of forward parking. As part of this scenario, the vehicle is required to park into a designated parking spot. Here is how the algorithm works. The vehicle is localizing itself thanks to its LiDAR sensors. And in this example, it's supposed to park at the location number 2. So it follows the path generated and conducts the necessary maneuvers to park itself to the designated spot with a high accuracy. In conclusion, field operational urban surround perception is realized thanks to the developed software building blocks for the specific use cases of passenger vehicle for low speed autonomy. Thanks for listening and your attention, and we will be more than happy to answer any questions you may have.